Pat Love back again from Love Healing Hearts, here to bring the second message that I'm dedicating to our new online church, God's Online Church of Love. Happy Resurrection, part two to this morning's resurrection message. And I will click in 1 second, don't go anywhere, and here we go.
We don't have to pull our hair out, you guys.
We don't have to pull our hair out.
Look at, God is, when he says, peace be still, he means, peace be still. I have been, after 3 years, I'm just going to tell this real quick. After 3 years of going through, running to God, it's like the Lord said something in my spirit. It's time. And I said, yeah, you're right. I've been carrying this. I've been running to you, but I've been carrying this. See, when you don't carry something anymore, even though the problem continues, you don't feel the pain. Now listen, I went in the backyard. I looked up at the stars, and I went like this. I said, Lord, I have to gesture with my hands. So you might want to do this with some of your problems.
I'm going to show you.
Lord, here's my jealousy. Here's my hurt. Here are my fears. Here are my anxieties. I was crying my eyes out, but I was serious as a heart attack.
That's right.
Here is my brokenness. Here is my husband. I gave it all to him. Here's his adultery. I can't take this. I can't handle it. So, what ended up happening? See, I'm not argumentative. I know how to argue. But I refuse to go there because it's a waste of energy when God can handle me. So for those of you who like to argue, yeah, go to God first before you start flying off of the mountain. What I ended up doing, by doing that night, the very next day, my ex-husband came home, guilt written all over his face, had just come out from a prostitute. This had been going on for the whole 8 years of our marriage. This is how deeply involved God is with our lives. I never again felt pain, jealousy, insecurity, anguish, anxiety, fear, betrayal.
Hello.
He and I just became good friends and good buddies. And I told the Lord, I knew after the second month, I had the right to divorce him. But I said, Lord, you were patient with me, and I was a mess. So as long as you want me to stay in this marriage, I may consult him about everything, you guys. As long as you want me to stay in this marriage, keep the love alive, even though there's no more romance. When you're ready for me to divorce, when you are ready, your timing, not mine, your rights, not mine. When you're ready for me to divorce, tell me by taking away the love. And one day, in the seventh year, the love was just gone. No anger, no resentment, no bitterness, none of that. God handled me. Do you hear me? Even though the problem never went away and he graduated to a full-blown extramarital affair, I was fine. And my pastor looked at me, why don't you tell him what? My pastor was freaking out. I was looking at him, I said, God's got me, I'm good. And I was. And I filed the divorce papers and everything was fine and dandy. We never became enemies. It wasn't necessary.
Thank you.
Listen, you guys, God knows what God has broken. And this is one of the things, talking about shedding light in our pathway. God showed me the reason he was involved with pornography was there was a damage done to him when he was a child. Now, I never knew it. He never told me. He may not have even remembered. But God showed me that. And when God gives you understanding, you're able to deal with situations and each other's faults so much easier. My late husband, this last one, he was a jewel. But one of the things he tended to have was a bossy spirit. And I asked the Lord, how do I deal with that? What's going on? Because I don't want to get offended or insulted.
Right.
And he really meant no harm. But what God showed me, just as plain as day, he's gifted to be a supervisor. He's got administrative skills.
That's right.
And because of that, he's always making sure all the ducks lined up in a row. And that stopped me from internalizing it. It was just a trait. It was one of his gifts. So we never had an issue with that. What I'm trying to say to you is life can be so much easier. Relationships between husband and wife, between son and father, daughter and mother, the brothers and sisters, they can be so much more. That can be so much richer when you're out of the equation.
Right.
When you move yourself out of the equation, the blinders come off. So when he says that he gives the gives sight to the blind, what he's telling you is he gives you understanding.
Right.
He gives you insight. He helps you realize what's really going on so that it's not about, what about me? 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 Do you see what he did to me? Do you see what they said to me? Do you know what? Do you know how that happened to me? That wasn't right how that went down for me. Me, 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 me. When you get me out of the way, your blindness move. Amen.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to read Luke chapter 4, and then we'll be just about done. Luke chapter 4, because we have to understand why Jesus is in our lives. This is not religion. This is not denominationalism.
Hello.
Okay, Luke chapter 4. We're reading verse 18. Through 21. This is Jesus in the synagogue. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal. Listen to this, you guys. He has sent me to heal the broken hearted. Some of you guys have gone through stuff since you were kids, and if you rehearsed it today, it would bring the same pain that was there when it first happened the day before. And some of you have things that happened 30, 40, 60 years ago that you've never gotten over.
You know it.
This is what Jesus came to do besides forgive us for sin. Excuse me. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and the recovering of sight to them that are blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised. There are women sitting right here, some of you men, who have gone through things when you were a child that you don't want anybody to know about. But it follows you everywhere you go. And you sit in church, happy Sabbath, and oh, it's good to see you all. Hugs. And you're laughing and joking and smiling and socializing over all that old, stale pain that has never gone anywhere. And that's what Jesus came and went through all the suffering for, to remove all that from our hearts. To preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And he closed the book and gave it again to the minister and sat down, and the eyes of all men were fixed on in the synagogue were fastened on him. And he began to say unto them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your hearing. And I say to you, Jesus is fulfilled in your hearing if you open up. You know, opening up and asking Jesus into your heart is not where it ends.
It's where it
starts.
That's
where it begins.
Right.
All the stuff, all your idiosyncrasies, all your fallacies, all of the areas that you can't give up, that you can't forgive. Some of you men are hooked on that internet, and you don't tell anybody. Some of you women are dealing with things that nobody knows about, even things you've done, sins you've committed that you're ashamed of, or things that have been done to you.
That's right.
Do you hear what I'm saying? Mm. That's what Jesus went through. Every stripe on his back was not to he just to heal us physically, but to heal us. Do you know how much further we could go in life if we would allow God into those areas where the skeletons are rattling in the closet? Those hidden reputations we don't want anybody to know about.
That's right.
The anger issues. Mm. The I can't help it. All of that. And I'm gonna cut it short because I know we got a long day. But I just want to say to you, please, please go to God. Don't carry that any longer. As long as you carry it, it's gonna hurt.
Right.
But when you really give it up, it really stops hurting. I promise you that, it really does. The situation may not change, but you know what happens inside of you while you do that? When you're giving it up to him, you're learning more mercy. You're learning how to love unconditionally. You're learning how to extend yourself beyond yourself, beyond your normal abilities. You're learning how to maneuver and navigate it. You recognize warning signs way ahead of time. So, oh, no, not touching that. Because the Holy Spirit is in you, talking to you. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. That's our navigational device. God bless you. And I hope and pray that we all get to see how Jesus is more than the resurrection and the life.
That's right.
He is everything we need in our lives.
Everything.
Let him lead you. Let him guide you. Ask him in where the hurt is. Ask him to heal you. Ask him to give you peace and understanding. And life will be so much easier. Yeah, you will go through. But you go through so much easier. In spite of the tears,
and right,
you will cry. But cry in his light. So much more rewarding.
That's right.
God bless you.
That's it. That's the message, you guys. I hope it encouraged your hearts. I'm so sorry I could not find a way to get it up, but for some reason the file was too large. So, happy resurrection. And I hope tomorrow is even a greater, brighter day, more encouraging for you. God bless you. Peace be still. In the name of Jesus. Amen.